I think you don't have to tell people who know their condition sometimes what to do. Peter didn't have to have instruction when he was drowning. He realized his condition and said, Lord, save me. And when the Lord saved him, I mean, of course I'm gonna walk with him. I think how it starts, like, let's go back to the top of this whole program. See how you see it. How do you see your life? Most people don't know that we're in trouble when we don't have Christ in our life. We're in trouble. The Bible says, I don't have to condemn the world that don't believe in me. If you don't believe, you're condemned already. Realizing how much trouble we are in without him creates the cry out. You know, you don't have to tell nobody how to cry out to God when they understand they're drowning in the pool of their own sins, and the root of most of the dysfunction in my relationship could be my disalignment with God. The root to dysfunction in my family or in my business, if I understood that the cause of most of the dysfunction is the sin in my life and me not being in right standards with God, if I realize I'm in a whole lot of trouble, I will run to the answer. I will run. A lot of, when I was in high school, I wanted to play basketball, right? But I needed certain credits for to be eligible to play ball. So I never really, you know, me and my teachers kind of had a love-hate relationship. But when I needed them credits, they were my best. I went there, I stayed extra after school. You know what I mean? I did extra credit. I went there instead of going to lunch. I went to the English class. I did what I had to do because I realized who I needed, you know what I mean, to be elevated. So you don't really need a whole bunch of instructions when you realize really where you are, because honestly, Matt, most people's instructions are going to be very different and personal. The Bible says I've written my laws on their minds and on their hearts. If God is telling me don't drink wine, that's my instruction in my first step in salvation. God might be telling you something different. This is the time to really seek the Lord. The Bible says that the 10 lepers, actually the 10 men that were lepers, they cried out to God. Nobody had to tell them what to do because they realized their circumstance and they realized he's the only one that can help us. So they cried out to God. He said, go show yourselves to the priest. And here we are. This is salvation, right? Or this is sanctification. They got saved. They got up and they began to go towards the priest. And the Bible says, as they went. As they went, they were healed. As they went. So that's sanctification. I'm doing what the Lord says. I got saved. I'm a new creature in Christ. Now, as I go, he'll perfect those things that concern me. He'll be strong in my weaknesses. He'll give me wisdom where I'm foolish. As I go, people of God, once you're saved, you cannot afford to not take the next step, because most your perfecting might be in the next step. Your health might be in the next step. Your wisdom might be in the next step. Whatever you do, don't just stand there. Do something. And when you seek the Lord, he'll give you, again, specific design, tailor made for your life as to what to do. So I don't think any prophet, any pastor, any man of God can literally tell you your next step unless God gives them the word for you. I think he wants you now to ask, seek, and knock. It's not that I don't have the answer, but I want you to ask, how bad do you want it? I want you to seek, how bad do you want it? I want you to knock, how bad do you want it? He sat there and watched Peter drown. He didn't just run to Peter's help when he started to drown. Can you imagine the Savior having the ability and the power to rescue him, but not move him? He didn't move until Peter asked, until he prayed, until he reached out, until he said something. And some of us are gonna just drown in the pandemic, drown in our sorrows, drown in poverty. We're so prideful, we won't even ask the Lord, what shall I do? What steps should I take? Because as soon as you ask, Lord, save me, he reaches down immediately and picks you up. And as Rich said, he walks with you the rest of the way. And so I think we're at a place now where we need to ask the Lord. Ask the Lord. Lord, I humbly ask you, what's your plan for me? You know the plans that you have for my life. We have become so pastor dependent. We have become so prophet dependent. We have become so church gatherings dependent that we don't even know how to talk to him. When the pandemic hit, the saints were scrounging, looking for a word. I couldn't believe how many believers were like, my pastor, I gotta call my pastor. Are we still streaming? Are we having a group? I couldn't believe how frantic the believers were for a word. I didn't see the world tearing down the doors of the church for a word. I saw the believers doing that. And that was kind of had me scratch my head a little bit, like, hey, as a leader, and I know we got, you know, Liv Church, shout out to Liv, I love you guys so much. As a leader, are we doing our job like Eli? When Samuel kept running to Eli and said, hey, did you call me? No, I didn't call you. Hey, did you call me? No. Third time he said, you know what? That's the Lord. Go tell him, hey, I'm your servant and I hear you. Am I doing my job as a leader pointing people to God and not just my voice? Because they know my voice, so they're going to keep running to me. It is our job as spiritual leaders and pastors to direct them to God. They need to be God-dependent now. I can't visit every house affected by the pandemic. Yes, we're streaming, and thank God for TBN. I watch this daily. However, your impartation is going to come from your personal relationship with God, and I pray that you hone that relationship, because therein is your wisdom, therein is your safety, therein is your protection, and therein is your provision. Like the, here's my last thing, like they put the blood on the doorpost. They heard God, they obeyed Him, they covered their house. The pandemic was outside, such a cry throughout all Egypt because of such death was in the land. But in the house of the believers who heard and obeyed, there was peace. There was provision, they all ate, and there was protection. They were safe from the death angel. So our strength, protection, peace, and provision comes from hearing the voice of God for you and your house.